大家好啊，我是 N1 Holdings 的 Ren，今天是2020年3月31号。昨天刷屏的新闻就是这个1300亿 JobKeeper 的这个援助啊，政府援助措施啊，就是为了让这个我们市场上的很多的 small business 在这个疫情期间呢，进入一个所谓的冬眠状态啊。政府是说法是 business hibernation。那这个冬眠状态之后呢，其实疫情之后呢，我们知道，很多的事情都会不一样了，比如说做生意的方式、经营企业的方式、个人重视的东西，比如说现在开始很多人去买 income protection，担心自己生病之后没有这个收入，这种都会有很多的改变，包括投资市场啊，投资的方式都会改变。比如说我们之前大家聊得比较沸沸扬扬的这个房东和这个业主租金方面的怎么去互相帮忙。互相体谅对方的难处嘛，那今天我也想顺便介绍一下我们一个客户吧，也是朋友，也是很多年的股东了，他呢是个医生想趁这个机会呢，以他的专业意见跟大家介绍一下，到底这次疫情我们需要注意什么，他作为一个医生，在疫情期间呢，怎么把他的这个诊所 clinic 转型，来帮助到大众。
Thank you for watching 一起聊。My name is Dr. Anthony Yap. I'm the principal doctor of MyHealth Sydney CBD, Barangaroo, and Sydney Harbour. The COVID-19 crisis in Australia, in China, across the world is a very serious threat to the health of a lot of us. And the Australian government is taking initiatives as well to help fight this disease on our shores. The government is subsidizing 100 new clinics, to fight COVID. For better screening and better testing, and to make sure that the growth of COVID-19 doesn't grow. My plan is to open up a clinic in conjunction with the government and take my team across to run this clinic for better screening of recent travelers and people who are ill. We're all in this together. It's important as what the government has told us, and in social media, you've realized that it's important to keep good hygiene, washing hands frequently, covering up where possible. Not coughing in public, coughing into your arms. Avoid handshaking, avoid close physical contact with anyone that you don't know well. It's important to keep social distance, and it's important to look after our elderly as well because they're susceptible and vulnerable to this illness. We're in this together. Remember, after all this settles down, we're going to see on the other side a healthier, better you. So see you at MyHealth Sydney CBD.
所以在这里啊，谢谢 Dr. Yap 给我们的介绍啊，给我们这些信息啊，非常非常重要啊，我们下次再聊，谢谢大家。